In this comparative study, I will analyze how individualism is an overarching theme in animated superhero films. The films of choice are The Incredibles, a 2004 Pixar film directed by Brad Bird, and Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, a 2018 Sony Studios film directed by Peter Ramsey, Rodney Rothman, and Bob Persichetti. Individualism, defined by vocabulary.com, is the belief and practice that every person is unique and self-reliant. The Incredibles and Into the Spider-Verse utilize this theme within their respective films, but do so under the different cultural contexts. The differences and similarities regarding the theme may be best understood after analyzing characterization, visual, and audible style in both films. But let us first understand these films a little bit. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is an adaptation of the original character Spider-Man, but with a twist that someone new is behind the web-slinger's mask. This film tells the origin story of Miles Morales as Spider-Man, and shows how the character develops from an awkward teenager into a confident superhero after undergoing hardships that precede his newfound confidence. The film is actually self-aware about these classic superhero tropes specific to Spider-Man, and is able to address them while still effectively utilizing them. The Incredibles is a story about Bob Parr, Mr. Incredible, and his family. The basic plot is that the character is in retirement and trying to relive his glory days, as opposed to the alternative, which would be to conform to society and aim to have a normal life. The issues that arise are about the conflict between the different ideals, as Mr. Incredible's wife, Elastigirl, attempts to build this normal life and suppress the things that make her family special, while her son questions and rebels. The main villain's ultimate goal is to kill off all the supers. He then eventually plans to sell his inventions in order to make everyone super.
And when everyone's super, no one will be.
The narrative and film elements that will compare and contrast these films are as follows. For narrative elements, origin, cliffhangers, and character originality will be analyzed. As for film elements, group dynamics, costuming, editing pace, non-diegetic graphics, music, and narration will be analyzed. Cultural context points include political versus social, or rather, more specifically, conformity versus identity. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse has a social context. It's a film about identity and developing self-expression through that unique identity. The different Spider-People and Pig share an identity but are still unique from each other, as the confidence in being who they are allows them to be successful and confident in their own ability. The protagonist Miles undergoes a journey to become more confident in himself, though it is a difficult one. It takes him the entire film to do so, and the obstacles aren't all physical, as the abstract nouns such as legacy, family pride, and indecisiveness hinder his inevitable growth. The Incredibles has a political context. It's a film about conformity and breaking from the mundane in order to be stable in one's family life. The political climate within the movie has banned the supers from fighting crime and saving lives. Those left of the supers are forced into hiding and made to suppress their powers and what makes them special. The mother, Helen Parr, abides by these new rules willingly, while the father, Mr. Incredible, finds it difficult to sustain a normal life. Their kids parallel them as Dash the son fights his conformity by rebelling in class and using his powers, while Violet, the daughter, wishes to be normal, so she can be a part of the mundane and conform to society and attempt to be with a boy. Dash actually has an interesting conversation with his mother about this on the way home from being sent to the principal's office.
But Dad always said our powers were nothing to be ashamed of. Our powers made us special.
Everyone's special, Dash.
Which is another way of saying no one is.
Comparison 1. Character. Group dynamics. Originality. Costuming. The characters in these two films are of course not the same, as The Incredibles were created for this specific film and didn't exist before 2004. Meanwhile, Spider-Man is a 60-year-old character created back in 1962 for the comic book medium. The inherent differences don't take away from their similar traits and dynamics, as the relationships between characters in The Incredibles is different than Into the Spider-Verse. The Incredibles have an obvious family dynamic, as it is a film about a family who express their differences realistically, which is ironic considering it's animated. This differs from the Into the Spider-Verse relationships, as it is more of a mixture of dynamics, as the Peter B. Parker character is a mentor-like figure, the Gwen Stacy character is a pseudo-love interest, and the other characters are like close acquaintances. While all have different relationships to Miles, they share an identity, as the spider emblem on their chest unifies them like soldiers, almost like how troops are in battle when representing a country. This is like The Incredibles, as their family name, so to speak, unifies them, but each individual is able to express themselves differently with their different powers. The costuming is also a factor into how the characters within the movie discuss the theme of individualism. In The Incredibles, the supers begin with very distinct costumes, even dedicating scenes to explaining the importance of costumes and how a superhero should have
no capes!
Then, a uniform is created and introduced for the family, which signifies how individualism can be expressed within conformity, and a balance of being a part of the collective, but still expressing your uniqueness in little ways. The costumes in Into the Spider-Verse are again much like a uniform, but the variety in each costume allows for the individualism and identity to be best expressed by the characters, as the message in the film is
anyone can wear the mask.
And even though it's the same mask, it's worn by very different individuals. Comparison 2. Visual style. Editing pace. Non-diegetic graphics. Origin story. The theme of individualism is not only how these two are significantly similar because the pace of both films is almost the same. They are both action-packed with comedic timing on point and pause to slow the pacing for the more heartfelt scenes.
I don't know what will happen.
Hey, we're superheroes. What could happen?
The uniqueness of Into the Spider-Verse use of non-diegetic graphics was to more fully create the feeling of a comic book come to life, as the scenes reflected panels from comic books rather than images from life. The Incredibles' decision to reflect the mundane in the format of animation also works well, as its message of individualism was captured by the contradiction of uniqueness within conformity, much like the contradiction of realism within animation. What both have but still differ on would be their narrative use of origin stories, as The Incredibles utilize an origin story to tell an origin story, and Into the Spider-Verse is a culmination of different characters' origin stories that support the main origin story of Miles Morales as Spider-Man. In order to establish this film's political context, in The Incredibles, the origin story is utilized as this period of the film could be labeled as the glory days that Bob attempts to relive. The social context Into the Spider-Verse regarding identity is aided by the plethora of origin stories in the film, as they are used to set expectations for what Miles should be, but is then realized by the character that in order to be what he should be, he needs to establish his own identity in order to be confident in himself and thus his abilities. Comparison 3. Audible style. Music, narration, cliffhanger. The setting is communicated and represented through the music in these films. The jazzy 50s lounge music in The Incredibles provides its own unique style, while also providing some context to the setting of the film, as it's implied to occur during a time when conformity in America was all the rage, as the American Dream white picket fence stereotype was very much evident at this time. Similarly, the hip-hop, rap, and R&B music define the Into the Spider-Verse setting as a modern urban area that is very much a platform for uniqueness to be displayed on a large scale. Again, we see the theme of individualism through the setting, thanks to the music. Now, narration is not present in The Incredibles. This is again due to the option to depict realism, but speaks to the conformity aspect of the narrative, as the lack of personal voice says something without saying anything at all. In contrast, Into the Spider-Verse uses narration to further stylize the film, as narration is very prominent in comic books, and knowing what a character is thinking internally is a given in that medium. It also uses narration to support the social context of identity, as the character Miles is attempting to develop his own identity, and oftentimes people look within to figure out that internal conflict. A cliffhanger is a common trope in the superhero genre, as its original medium, comic books, were serials that were episodic and often left stories open for more. The to-be-continued trope is utilized in both films, as The Incredibles utilize it to wrap up the movie, as the aftermath, after the climax, was important to show in order to conclude with a nod to the film's message about contradicting balance of conformity and expression of uniqueness. The utilization in Into the Spider-Verse was to set up a multiverse which creates opportunities for endless sequels and spin-offs, which is often done by other films within the genre. The origin story concludes, which means the character's story begins. Conclusion. What the films reveal about the genre is that uniqueness can still be expressed within the collective, so individualism is a theme that is explored but not necessarily agreed with. The Incredibles' message is that you can balance conformity and individuality, and Into the Spider-Verse suggests that a sense of unity can be felt among an individual based on a shared identity.